perhaps you said, and that's how I save the world. So Jesus is the ultimate superhero, and because of who he is and what he's done for us, we can celebrate John and Caitlin's heroic decision to enter into the covenant bond of matrimony for the rest of their lives. This unbreakable bond was created by God the Father, established as a sacrament by Jesus, his Son, and is sustained and strengthened by the Holy Spirit. And much like our first married couple, Adam and Eve, who were created in the image and likeness of God, John and Caitlin will be recreated into a visible sign and icon of God's love and for his people as they share in the very life of the Blessed Trinity by the grace of the sacrament. You know, God created everything out of nothingness and then declared it to be very good. But out of all of Scripture, all of sacred Scripture, all the writings, God only declared one thing not good, and that was for man to be alone. And soon John and Caitlin will never have to be alone, because they will be able to share everything, including the worship of the one true God whose love forever honors, protects, forgives, and saves. And when the rains, floods, and winds of this world buffet their life together, they won't have to worry about their marriage collapsing, because they have built it on the solid rock of faith. And by wisely listening and acting on Christ's words, they have the grace to heroically start and raise a family to love God and love neighbor. You know, some people think that marriage is a 50-50 proposition, and that's probably why so many marriages fail. Because a real marriage requires a total 100% giving of each other to one another for life. Years ago, there was a popular movie called Love Story with Ryan O'Neal and Alan McGraw that coined the phrase, you probably saw the poster way back then if you're old enough to remember, love means never to have to say you're sorry. And everyone goes, aw, how beautiful. What a bunch of Hollywood crap. I mean, because in marriage, couples have to constantly reconcile and say that they're sorry to each other. Because even though they don't try to hurt each other by what they say and do, we're all human and sinners, so we inevitably do cause hurts. But imagine if all husbands and wives promise never to hurt one another intentionally, and then agree that if hurts do happen, that they will talk about it right away while assuming that it wasn't on purpose. That way, I mean, how many hours and days of unhappiness could be eliminated in a marriage if through that simple discussion and mutual, every once in a while, I'm sorry for any part that I played in any hurt? That kind of heroic love and faithfulness requires respect, humility, and sacrifice. It involves sharing and accepting the very best and the very worst of each other and choosing to love one another anyways, forever. Just like God does. You know, there's a song by Martina McBride that I think all couples should aspire to throughout their married life together. It goes something like this. They drank their anniversary glass, a silent moment passed, then they kissed. She knows there's something on his mind, he'll tell her in due time what it is. He said, I've never built your mansion on the hill, or warmed you in the Spanish sun. I simply blink my eye and think of years by, of all the things we've never done. She smiled of the solution to what our society and world needs most today: holy marriages and holy families. And through, with, and in Jesus Christ, who is the only real true superhero, John and Caitlin can be his sidekicks as they help to save the world, one couple, one love, and one family at a time. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.